Yo, math class. Let's learn it. All right, stop. Collaborate and listen. Phillips is back with a brand new invention. Someone has taught me rightly. I cross-reduce daily and nightly. Will it always work? Yo, that's a no. Turn on your brain and let's go. To the extreme, I like a problem with action. Light up a class and multiply with fractions. Solve. Rush the students that boom. I'm filling your brain till there's no room. Touchdown. Reduce up and down. Check for factors. Don't mess around. Use it or leave it. You better decide. Use common factors. Numbers don't lie. If there are problems, yo, I'll solve them. Throw up the bones. You better reduce them.
Throw the bones.
Touchdown.
Throw the bones. Throw the bones.
Touchdown.
Throw the bones.
Now that the class is solving and you are begging for another problem, throw up the bones and look for common factors in both digits. You get it? What goes in 20 and 15? It's 5, you see. 5 goes in 24 times in 3, 4, 15. You say, whoa, Mr. P, that can't be. You must be kidding me. Aren't we in math class? This can't be so easy. And I just shrug, cause I know you will love the next step, the touchdown. Look up and down and you will notice numbers come into focus, like 5 and 4, 3 and 9. They are one of a kind. 5 and 4, no common factors to explore, so don't worry. 3 and 9 will work just fine. Don't get in a hurry. We know that 3 goes into both numbers 1 and 3 times. If you divide, it's like clockwork. That works all of the time. Now don't forget how to do all of the basic steps. Just multiply and cross and you get 5/12. Oh yeah.
Throw the bones.
Touchdown.
Throw the bones.
Touchdown.
Throw the bones.
Touchdown.
Throw the bones.
Touchdown. Touchdown. Touchdown.
Damn.